She said, I am the canon this afternoon. My brothers and sisters, through sin we are alienated from God and from one another, and from our very self. But in this wisdom, God provided a way back, beginning from the sinless conception of the Virgin Mary. Through her would come the Savior of the world. Truly divine and truly human, our Lord Jesus Christ, who is himself our reconciliation. May the celebration of this Eucharist be our song of thanksgiving and praise today on the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Virgin Mary. Our presiding and homilist of this Eucharist is Father Kevin. Please stand. The parish family of St. Margaret was sure to be a welcoming community. In that spirit, we invite you to introduce yourself by the name of those assembled. The end of the hymn is number 697 in this edition, Song of Mary. Sing of Mary, number 697.
Reading from the book of Genesis. After the man Adam had eaten of the tree, the Lord God called the man and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." Then he asked, "Who told you that you were naked? You have eaten then from the tree of which I have forbidden you to eat." The man replied, "The woman whom you put here with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and so I ate it." The Lord God then asked the woman, "Why did you do such a thing?" The woman answered, "The serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly shall you crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head while you strike at his heel." The man called his wife Eve, because she became the mother of all the living. St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens, as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ, in accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of his grace that he granted us in the beloved. In him we are also chosen, destined in accord with the purpose of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intention of his will, so that we might exist for the praise of his glory, we who first hope in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Yesterday, I was at a luncheon for
which I've been going to for like 22 years now, retired for police officer luncheon. It always was in, you ever been to the casino in a park in Jersey City? Not there anymore. But we've been doing it down the Shore Casino recently. So I go down there, for luncheon. I open a prayer, and then I'm sitting at the table with all the retired guys, of course. And one of them had heard my homily some years ago. Have you never heard? You might have, you're probably aware, unless you've never been to my homily on this day. He asked somebody else, one of the younger guys, in fact, a friend of mine who just retired last week, he said, "Do you know what the Immaculate Conception is?" And he said, "Yeah, well, that's when Jesus, and that's what most people would think today is." Okay? It's not. So it was confusing because that was what we have in the gospel today. There's two different conceptions that we honor in Catholicism. Today, the Immaculate Conception and the Virginal Conception. Right? The Virginal Conception was, actually we celebrate that on March 25th. We call it the Annunciation. Okay. March 25th. And then what's 9 months after March 25th? Christmas, December 25th. Today is the Immaculate Conception. This is when Mary was conceived in the womb of her moms, in the womb of her mother. Unlike the Virginal Conception, Mary was conceived the same way you and I were between intercourse between her parents, Joachim and Anna. However, what God did, and this is what this feast of Solemnity is about. God gave her a special grace in light of what he would ask of her. The time was right for the coming of the Messiah. So he singled out Mary and he kept Mary free from original sin. Was Mary the only one in history conceived without original sin? I'm not talking about Jesus here. Sister?
I would say yes.
What about Adam and Eve? Likely Adam and Eve were conceived because there was no sin until Adam and Eve sinned. You follow me? Now, this is a theory, I don't know if it's a fact, but this is Adam and Eve, okay, were conceived, okay. There was no sin yet in the world until they sinned. So once they sinned and sin came into the world, it affected every human being since. Original sin. This grace that we're celebrating today is that God kept her free from original sin. He gave her a special grace. Normally original sin is washed away from us through what? Baptism, right? With Mary, it was washed away through this grace, through the Immaculate Conception. So another question, did this grace, the special grace that God gave Mary at the moment of her conception, could Mary have sinned? Yes or no? Could she have sinned? Yes, she could have. She was human, just like us. She could have done what Adam and Eve did, sin, but she didn't. How do we know this? And how do we know about this? Hail Mary. also if she had committed a sin during her life, short life at the time, could she have been full of grace? No. So that's what today's all about. And it's a reminder to us of God's involvement with human history. And at this key moment, okay, so we're assuming this happened somewhere in the area of 20 BC. All right? Most people think Jesus was born 4 years before BC, but they screw up the calendar somewhere along the way. That's particularly born 4 years before himself. Assuming Mary was in a range of 15 years old, all right, this might have probably happened somewhere around 20 BC. And it's a reminder that now God, always involved with human history, always involved with humans, now is getting more involved, leading to ultimately, obviously, Mary, 15, 16 years later, agreeing, cooperating with God, agreeing to be a receptacle of the Son of God in her womb, and then her being there at the moment of redemption, watching her son die on the cross. Please stand. I believe.
Friends, I've asked us to remember Terry Avondale, when you pray.
prayers may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Graciously accept the saving sacrifice which we offer you, O Lord, on the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And grant that as we profess her on account of your prevenient grace, be untouched by any stain of sin, through her intercession we may be delivered from all our faults, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. But you preserved the most blessed Virgin Mary from all stain of original sin, that in her, endowed with the rich fullness of your grace, you might prepare a worthy mother for your Son, and signify the beginning of the Church, his beautiful bride without spot or wrinkle. She, the most pure virgin, was to bring forth her Son, the innocent Lamb, who would wipe away our offenses. You placed her above all others to be for your people an advocate of grace and a model of holiness. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Similar way when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Saint Margaret and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Teaching, we dare to say,
Father, who art in heaven,
weeks and our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of the Church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of presence.
Thank you.
May the sacrament you have received, the Lord our God, heal us from wounds of that fault, for which in the same way we preserve the Blessed Mary in her Immaculate Conception, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Our concluding hymn is 698 in the music issue, Song of Mary, number 698.